Hi everyone, today I'm going to talk about the difference between RANS and URANS. RANS stands for the Reynolds Average Navier-Stokes equations, which we can see here, while URANS stands for unsteady RANS equations, as is shown here. The difference between RANS and URANS is basically the presence of the temporal derivative of velocity components in the URANS equations, which is absent in the RANS equations, as we can see here. In other words, in the URANS equations, the transient term is retained. In both the RANS and URANS equations, U and P are ensemble mean components of velocity and pressure, respectively. Sij is the mean strain rate tensor, which is expressed in terms of the gradient of the mean velocity components, as shown here. Tau ij, as we can see here in the RANS and URANS equations, is the turbulent tensor or Reynolds stress tensor and is written like this. The mean product of the fluctuating velocity components. It is crucially important to note that the RANS and URANS frameworks are based on ensemble averaging, not time averaging. To understand the difference between the ensemble averaging and time averaging, this figure here, it shows the ensemble average together with the time average of the velocity magnitude in a point within a turbulent flow with respect to time. Therefore, as can be inferred from this figure, the ensemble average will in general vary with time unless the turbulent flow is temporarily stationary. In practice, we often approximate the ensemble average by the time average in temporarily stationary turbulent flows. You can learn more about the ensemble average by watching the video in my channel entitled RANS Equations, Ensemble Average versus Time Average. To understand better the difference between the RANS and URANS method, this figure here shows schematically the results of a velocity calculation within a turbulent flow using the large eddy simulations, which is shown here by LES together with RANS and URANS simulations. As can be inferred, the URANS simulation, due to the use of ensemble averaging, is capable of capturing the very large fluctuations in the mean flow, while the RANS simulation, due to the absence of the temporal derivative of velocity components, captures only the time average value of the velocity. Therefore, RANS is based on mean flow quantities and considers the flow field to be steady state. However, unsteady RANS, i.e. URANS, has the ability to resolve the largest scales of a turbulent flow, which are caused by, for example, statistically unsteady vortex shedding. The time step needed for URANS simulations is determined by low frequency phenomena and should be much larger than the turbulent time scales. The difference between RANS and URANS method can also be explained using the turbulence kinetic energy spectrum as presented here in this figure. URANS resolves the largest scales of a turbulent flow while it models the effect of the rest of the vortices down to the Kolmogorov scale. On the other hand, in the RANS method, the turbulence is accounted for by modeling the effect of all the turbulence scales on the mean flow. This is the end of this video. I hope you found this video useful. Please let me know what you think about this video by leaving a comment in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video, and for further upcoming videos, please subscribe to this channel.